I am a trapper. I am an outdoorsman. I am a Christian. Just for the record, my status is not necessarily in that order. Matter of factly, Christianity is number one. My faith means everything to me. Without my faith in God, my trust in God, I would be nowhere, nothing at all. You might look at me and say, why trap? Why are you a trapper? Why are you an outdoorsman? Quite frankly, it's my heritage. And if I must say, I'm rather good at it. If I wasn't good at what I do in trapping, I'd starve to death. It is my livelihood. It is my heritage. The founding fathers, matter of fact, let's go back a little further than that. God Almighty gave me the right and the duty to manage conservation of wildlife, and all of the animals were put into my care, your care. And what we do with that will determine how things turn out. You know, it's sort of funny. Funny in an odd type of way, not in a laughter type, but it's sort of odd and ironic that the very people that come down on us for trapping, hunting with a recurve bow, whatever, the very same people that come down on us have no problem taking the life of a little unborn child. Imagine that. Try to even figure it out. It's beyond normal human comprehension. You know what I've noticed over the 50 some years that I've been in the outdoors trapping and hunting and whatever? What I've noticed is that everybody that ever went hunting with me had some idea that there was a God somewhere. But on the other hand, it seems as though the anti-hunters are also anti-God. They don't want anything to do with your hunting. They don't want anything to do with your God. Because what the Bible does, it explains thoroughly our role as human beings created in the image of God is to be. And they want no part of that. Because why? Because of the wicked one that lives inside. And he lived inside of all of us until Jesus Christ came and made a way for us to escape. I guess that's sort of why sometimes when I go into the woods, I feel like that I'm escaping from the hustle and bustle of life and the things of life and the burdens of life. You get out there and all you see is what God did, what God is doing. And I can become a part of that. We look about us, we see all kinds of excuses that are being made about serving God, about walking with God and doing what is right according to the Word of God. And folks are saying that it it's a weak person's religion. Well, I have to agree with them because I am weak, but he is strong. But on the other hand, because he is strong, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. So there I stand. The further I travel down this road of life, and the closer that I get to the stop sign, I'm reminded of this with a joy in my heart. Because of what Jesus did, I am strong. And because of what Jesus did, there's a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. And you might say, Mr. Stevens, what if you're wrong? What if it's just a figment of your imagination or a wise tale that someone spun many years ago? Well, what if it's not?